हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल ब्रेन अलाइव। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस कलेक्टर टू बेस बायसिंग मेथड। हेयर दिस इज द सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ कलेक्टर टू बेस बायसिंग। इन दिस मेथड आरबी इज कनेक्टेड बिटवीन द कलेक्टर एंड द बेस टर्मिनल, अनलाइक फिक्स्ड रजिस्टर बायसिंग मेथड इन विच दिस आरबी इज कनेक्टेड बिटवीन द बेस एंड वीसीसी। दिस मेथड प्रोवाइड्स अ कंसिडरेबल इम्प्रूवमेंट इन स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग पॉइंट्स। सो दिस मेथड इज बेटर देन फिक्स रजिस्टर बायसिंग मेथड। नाउ वी विल एनालाइज द सर्किट टू फाइंड आउट द रिक्वायर्ड वैल्यू ऑफ आर बी सो दैट ए रिक्वायर्ड जीरो सिग्नल कलेक्टर करंट फ्लोज इन द सर्किट। टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस आर बी वी विल अप्लाई केवीएल इन द इनपुट साइड। दिस इज इनपुट साइड एंड दिस इज आउटपुट साइड। नाउ द इक्वेशन विल बी दिस वी सी सी इक्वल्स टू आई इंटू आर एल, मीन्स दिस आई इज इक्वल्स टू आई सी प्लस आई बी, बिकॉज दिस करंट आई डिवाइड्स एट दिस नोड इंटू आई बी एंड आई सी। सो दिस आई इज इक्वल्स टू आई सी प्लस आई बी। सो द लूप इक्वेशन इन इनपुट साइड विल बी वी सी सी इक्वल्स टू आई सी प्लस आई बी इंटू आर एल प्लस आर बी इंटू आई बी प्लस वी बी, वोल्टेज बिटवीन बेस एंड एमीटर। So this is the required equation of KVL on input side. Now we know this IB is much less than this IC. So we can neglect this IB. Now the equation becomes VCC equals to IC into RL plus IB into RB plus VBE. Now we will manipulate the equation to find this RB. So this RB equals to VCC minus IC into RL minus VB upon IB. We have taken this term and this term on this side and this IB on in the denominator. So equation becomes this one. We will mark this equation as 1. Now we will write loop equation for output circuit. This is the circuit. This is output circuit. So the loop equation will be VCC equals to IC into IB into RL plus VCE. So the equation will be VCC equals to IC plus IB into RL plus VCE. As we know, this IB is much less than this IC, so we can neglect IB. Now the equation becomes VCC equals to IC into RL plus VCE. Now after manipulating this equation, we will get VCE equals to VCC minus IC into RC. So we will mark this equation as 2. Now using this one equation and two equation, now we will put VCE in place of this. This is VCC minus IC into RC. This is VCC minus IC into RC. So we can write VCE in place of this value. So the equation becomes RB equals to VCE minus VB upon IB, because this VBE also much less than this value VCE, so we can neglect this VBE. Now the equation becomes RB equals to VCE upon IB. As we know, IC equals to beta IB, so IB equals to IC upon beta. Now we'll put the value of this IB in this equation. Now the RB becomes RB equals to VC upon IC upon beta. So RB equals to beta VCE upon IC. This is the equation which gives the value of required RB. Now to determine the operating point, we will find equations for IB, VC and IC. Now first we will find the equation for IB. To find the equation for IB, will again apply in KVL in the input side of the circuit. So the loop equation for input side of the circuit is VCC equals to IC plus IB into RL plus IB into RB plus VBE. So this is the loop equation for this circuit. As we know, IC equals to beta IB, so we can put beta IB in place of this IC. So the equation becomes this one. Now we'll take IB common from in this term. So the equation becomes this one. Now we know IB is here and also here. So we will take IB common from this and this term. So the equation becomes this one. Now we will take this term to the left side. So the equation become this one, VCC minus VBE. Now we will take this term to the right side in the denominator. So the equation becomes this. Now as we know, this VBE is much less than this value, and this beta has a high value, so one can be neglected. So we can neglect this term and this one. So the approximate equation for IB is this one, VCC upon RB plus beta RL. So this is the final equation for IB. Now for determining VCE, we will apply KVL to the output side. So loop equation for output side will be VCC equals to IC plus IB into RL plus VCE. So the equation will be VCC equals to VCE plus IC plus IB into RL. As we know, this IB is much less than this value, so we can neglect this IB. So the equation becomes this one. Now after manipulating this equation, we can find VC equals to VCC minus IC into RL. So this is the equation to find out VCE. Now we will find the stability factor for collector to base biasing. For find stability factor, we will write the complete exact equation for IB without neglecting anything. So we will again apply KVL in the input side. So loop equation for input side will be VCC equals to IC plus IB into RL plus IB into RB plus VB. So this is the loop equation for input side of the circuit. Now we will open this bracket, so the equation becomes this one. Now we will take IB common from this term and this term, so the equation becomes this one. Now we will find IB. So we will take this term and this term to the right side and this term in the denominator of the right side. So the equation for IB will be this one. Now we will differentiate this equation with respect to IC. As VCC and VB are constant, so the differentiation of these two terms will be zero. So the differentiation with respect to IC of this term will be RL upon RL plus RB. So after differentiating IB with respect to IC, we will get minus RL upon RL plus RB. As we know, the general equation for stability factor is this, S equals to 1 plus beta upon 1 minus beta delta IB upon delta IC. Now we will put this equation, means value of this delta IB upon delta IC here. So we will put this here. So the equation becomes this. So we will solve this equation. So we will get this one, 1 plus beta upon 1 plus beta RL upon RL plus RB. After observing this equation, we can find that S will be less than beta plus 1. This beta plus 1 is the value of stability factor in case of fixed resistor biasing. So we can observe here that stability factor for collector to base biasing is less than beta plus 1. So this method provides some stability of the operating point, as the stability factor is less here. Now we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of this biasing method. As we know, this biasing method contains only one resistor, so the circuit arrangement is simple, and also this provides some sort of stabilization. And the disadvantages are, the stability factor is quite high, so operating point does not change. And this method also provides negative feedback. This is disadvantage, because we know this is the output terminal of this amplifier. We take output from collector terminals, and this collector terminal is connected back to the input side, means base. So this method provides negative feedback. Due to negative feedback of AC signals, this reduces the gain of the amplifier, and this reduction of gain is not desirable. Now we will see how stabilization is achieved in this biasing method. Suppose due to increase in temperature, this ICBO means leakage current increases, or due to replacement of the transistor, this beta increases. So as this term increases, this IC also increases. As this IC increases, this term also increases. As the increase in this term reduces, this VCE as this VC is directly proportional to this IB, so IB also reduces. This also decreases. This decrease in IB, this IB is also used here. So this decrease in IB balance this increase. So in this way, this decrease keeps the IC almost constant or stable. So in this way, stabilization is achieved in this method. Now I hope you got the topic clearly. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching the video.